Hi, this is Judi at Judi in the Kitchen. Not long ago, I made a video on the Dirty Dozen and Clean 15 food list, and someone has asked me how to go about getting the chemical residues off their foods. So I've done a little research on this, and I have some references in the description box below. There's a variety of things that we can do. There's a whole world of videos out there of people that have done a variety of things, use different methods. I tried to focus on things that I knew for a fact would work. So I found some information that was proven by science, and that's what I am honing in on. First of all, we know that we want to wash our produce under running water. Okay, so that will help. It will not remove all the residues off of your foods, but that certainly does help to some extent. Another thing that was found, of course, is that we could peel some things, but there are peel fruits and vegetables, like I peel apples that are conventionally grown, but there can even be some amount of chemical residue that was soaked on into the apple, but it would be a relatively small amount. And you're going to remove most of it by peeling the apple if you choose to do that, if it's a conventionally grown apple. Another way that was found effective in removing chemical residues was using straight white vinegar. That would be rather expensive to do. A lot of people use white vinegar and dilute it. I'm not sure how effective that actually is when the literature said straight vinegar would do it. I would feel like straight vinegar might give flavor to grapes. For instance, if I soaked my grapes in straight vinegar, I don't think I want to do that. Another way that they found was using a 10% salt solution, which would be 1 part salt to 9 parts water. Let's say 1 tablespoon of salt to 9 tablespoons of water, which is a little bit more than a half a cup. That's not going to go very far unless you're soaking blueberries or something very small like that. So that in itself may be effective, but it also sounds a little expensive to me. So the one thing that I honed in on that science found was even more effective than bleach when it came down to removing chemical residue, and I would not use bleach, was using a baking soda and water solution. The consensus was 1 teaspoon of baking soda to 1 cup of water. So what I have found and just settled with is 1 to 2 teaspoons of baking soda per cup of water, and that way I've got a little bit extra in there. It's food safe, it's effective, it's not going to hurt anything, and that actually is going to go a long way as far as volume when we're dealing with larger produce. And so I'm going to demonstrate how this has worked for me. And one reason I want to, short story I want to tell on this is why it's important for us, me and my husband in particular. A while back I bought some grapes and we both got a pretty bad headache right away after eating the grapes in with our salad. And he came to me and commented to me, and I was pretty sick from a headache at the same time. We concluded it was the grapes. It was the first time I bought those from that particular country in as far back as I knew. And so I took the grapes and they went out in the garbage because they were so tainted, neither one of us could eat them. Well, the grapes that I'm going to demonstrate today are from that same country. And I managed to treat them earlier. I tested them with what I'm going to show you with the baking soda and water, and neither one of us got a headache. So that tells me that this method actually does remove a great deal, if not all, of the chemical residue that's on them. Now, I don't have a way of physically testing them. I'm just going by our personal reactions and also by the scientific literature that I found. And again, there's a link below. I'll show you what I read. So, onto the sink. Okay, I have some table grapes here that were conventionally grown, and I'm going to first rinse them with running water, and I'll use filtered water here. Rinse them first with running water. If you really want to get them off, I would take these grapes off of the stems and try to agitate them some and really, really give them a solid rinse. But we're going to do this the quick way. Okay, now I have a bowl, and I'm going to actually measure this out and see how much water it's going to take to fill this bowl. That was 2 cups. Four cups. We've got 5 cups in there. And so the tablespoon equals 3 teaspoons. So there's 3, and I'm going to go ahead and use 2 tablespoons. So we've got 5 cups of water and 6 tablespoons of baking soda. Now I just want to stir this until that baking soda dissolves. Looks pretty funky. It's all cloudy like. Now I'm going to put the grapes in there and hope that I can get these to be submerged as much as possible. I may break some off the stems here so that I can get them submerged as much as possible. I want these things to really be soaking in this water. And I'm actually going to set the timer on the stove and time it for 15 minutes. I want this to go the maximal amount of time, and that is supposed to allow the baking soda to actually break down the chemical residue that's on these grapes. And I'll be back with you after 15 minutes. It has been right at 15 minutes, and so we're going to give these guys a really good rinse. I'm going to start by just rinsing them in the bowl, but then I'm going to rinse them under running water with my little strainer. So I just want to start with giving them a good rinse this way, because I think the bowl is going to be a little bit easier. But I can tell when I just agitate these grapes a little bit, they feel squeaky clean. They don't feel like they have the residue on them that they did initially. When I first took them out of the bag, they just feel a whole lot cleaner. All right, so now I want to start rinsing them this way. I'm going to give them as much of an agitation as I can, trying not to take them off the stems as much as I can help it. But according to the science, they've tested this with baking soda and water and found that the baking soda actually helps to degrade the chemical residues that are on the produce. And my husband and I can attest to the fact that it made a difference, because we were actually able to eat these grapes that I had to throw out before. We were able to eat them without getting sick off of them from the residues that are on there. I'm going to let these drain really well. Dab them dry with paper towels and
put them in the refrigerator in a container where they are not airtight, because I think they're going to develop mold being all wet if I put them in the refrigerator in an airtight container.
This is a very safe, effective, inexpensive way that's proven by science to get chemical residues off the conventionally grown produce that we have. It worked for us. Neither one of us got a headache out of these grapes earlier when I threw them away a long time ago when I bought them, the same type of grapes. So it works for us. I hope it works for you. Put some comments in the section below and let me know how it works for you. This is Judi at Judi in the Kitchen. Have a great day.